You have to turn the negative into a positive. Because at the end of it all, if you can sit back and wait, if you can wait 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 12 years and you get to that point where you finish, that's the feeling. 12 years to get there. That's what keeps you going. You gotta feel, I'm doing it for 1 second. 1 second. You cross the finish line, it's over. It's not the 1 second, it's the 12 years. It's the 12 years that I want. It's not the race, it's the 12 years. Why you did it? Not the win. No. Being a perfectionist is the worst thing that happened to a person. You never live. I lost that 106 pounds. That was the biggest trophy of my entire life. I didn't care if I graduated in the same track. I didn't care. What I just accomplished in that time frame is massive.
Yeah.
I don't know. There was no trainer. It was funny about this. We talk about mental toughness nowadays. It's like the biggest grade. When I grew up, it was just suck it up. Make it happen. You had to figure out. Figure it out, man. All these nuggets that I gained along the way, that's what it was about. It wasn't about the trident. The journey getting there was harder than going through it. That's the whole thing about life, man. It's that journey that makes you who you are. I reflect back now. There's times now where I will reflect back on my first 100-mile race. Through that, it'll give me the same exact feeling. Most of the stuff I do, I'm training for those moments. Those moments when I was at mile 70 and I had 30 more miles to go and I crapped up my back and pee and blood down my leg. I had 30 miles to go. There's only so much someone cheering can do for you.
Right.
When you start to dive back in the cellar of your mind and you're pulling out all these tactics, all these mental tactics to get through this 30 miles when you're in the worst shape of your life and no one's coming to save you and you get through that.